Afternoon. We're live. Let's go. Let's have a good time, right. Everybody.
Christmas.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Welcome good morning. To CSL West Georgia's Christmas program 2020. We have a wonderful show for you, and we're getting ready to start. Mike, take it away.
All right. Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome. Thank you for your patience, and thank you for joining us in the spirit of perfect harmony. We are the Center for Spiritual Living West Georgia. We study and practice the philosophy and science of the mind we know as God. And with our spiritual presence and our participation in the service this morning, we create a higher state of consciousness, manifest love, and carry that love throughout the next week. Our Reverend Sandra Jackson, Reverend Dr. Sandra Jackson has put together a special program for today. And at this time, we will proceed with the service.
Thank you, Mike. That was absolutely wonderful. Floyd, our wonderful practitioner, opening invocation. Thank you, Floyd.
You're all welcome. Well, it's good to see everyone again. Literally, I can see you. So now is a wonderful time to leave behind all the chaos and unpleasantness of the past year. And so let's go within and know that the one life created me out of itself in order to rejoice in its universe. And I am the free expression of God's life, vitally alive in the infinite creation. My consciousness now selects and accepts the good that is mine by divine right. It is my rich inheritance. It nourishes my mind, and it maintains me in health and abundance. It is the joy of my soul. And I am not intrigued by the negatives of the world. I deny any and all suggestions of anything less than God, less than the all good. I am a spiritual being living effectively here and now, and I willingly discipline my consciousness to the end that infinite mind shall be recognized in all I am. I keep my attention on the good I desire, and I know it is a divine idea manifesting by means of me. That which I have chosen is now mine, and I am grateful for it, and so it is.
Thank you, Flora, for those wonderful words of wisdom. It's great seeing you again. Now we have the incomparable Cynthia and Connie gracing us with a wonderful song. Thank you, Cynthia and Connie. Take it away, Cynthia.
I think she's muted.
Oh, you're muted.
All right, here I am. You got me now?
Yeah.
Okay. It's been Connie and I's pleasure to be with you making music all year, and we look forward to next year. And we're going to do a Christmas song everybody knows.
You can join in.
Yes. Heavenly peace.
from heaven afar. Heavenly host, sing hallelujah. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born. Silent night, holy night, Son of God, love's pure light, radiance beams from thy holy face, with the dawn of redeeming grace, Jesus, born at thy birth, Jesus, Lord,
as always, Cynthia, that is wonderful. As always, that is wonderful. Now we're going to be hearing a wonderful reading about Christmas from Lily. Thank you, Lily. Take it away. And Lily, I think you are muted.
Okay, can you hear me now? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Christmas reading. Christmas is a story and also an experience. The story is about the birth of Jesus to Mary and Joseph, who have traveled a far distance and arriving late found all the inns closed. Mary delivers the child in a stable manger. They are soon joined by shepherds and wise men who mark the child as a special being. While this is a wonderful story for children, as we mature and understand Christmas as more than a story of long ago, it becomes a present day and personal experience. This experience is about the birth of the Christ consciousness within the individual person. Christmas is about birthing the Christ consciousness and our individual awareness. It is coming into conscious awareness that we are divine. The Christ consciousness is the complete and perfect I am. And while this awareness can and does come to us throughout the year, Christmas time, like our birthdays, is a time to focus our attention clearly and celebrate our divinity. It is time to remember and to celebrate the Christ consciousness, which is the radiant joy and love within us. It is the creative spirit within us that gives us the wisdom and power to transform our own lives and the world in which we live. It is the source of our life and frees us from all forms of limitation. The Christ spirit within us is the light that shines in the darkness, bringing healing and making whole those broken places of our lives. Christmas is a time to recognize, to remember, and to celebrate not just the story of a long ago experience, but the ever-present eternal Christ consciousness that is our now life. And so it is.
That was absolutely wonderful. Thank you, Lily. Now we have a wonderful song. Marcia is going to sing a wonderful song, but we would not be here without Marcia. Marcia is our operations manager, our director. Marcia is our everything. And she's going to grace us with a wonderful song. Thank you, Marcia. Take it away.
Thank you. Okay, you made me laugh. I have to get it back together. All right, here we go. All right.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy was born to make you new? This child that you deliver would soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Whoa. Mary, did you know? The deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know your baby boy was Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know your baby boy would one day rule the nation? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great I am.
Wow, 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 wow. That's my favorite song. And I have to get it together because my eyes are watering. And we can't have that. Thank you, Marcia. That was absolutely wonderful. Ajika, a wonderful member of CSL, West Georgia, is going to be doing a reading about Kwanzaa. Ajika, please take it away.
Thank you so much, Dorothea. Thank you all. Kwanzaa is a product of creative synthesis. Kwanzaa is not a religion, but a cultural practice. Kwanzaa is a celebration of the first fruit and the harvest on the African continent. Kwanzaa, the value and practice of gathering of the people, is the first and foundational common aspect of African first fruit celebrations, which went into the development of Kwanzaa. Kwanzaa gets its name from the Swahili phrase, Matunde ya Kwanzaa. Here, Matunde means fruits and ya Kwanzaa means first. Kwanzaa is about a recommitment to cultural values. Kwanzaa values that serve as a grounding and social glue for the community. Kwanzaa includes a process of reassessment, both personally and collectively, family, community, nation, the practice of recommitment to moral and social excellence, celebration of the past, reverence of our ancestors. To commemorate the past is also to commemorate the struggles, the deeds, of the people, to honor the narrative of the struggle, to shape their world in their own image and interest. Libations are performed in honor of our ancestors. During libations, their names are called out in remembrance and praise. Intercessions and blessings are invoked, thanking the ancestors before the beginning of any major celebration. So for this one, I call the ancestor of Deborah Hall, my mother, my grandmother, Ruth Kyer Simmons, Ashe. It is considered a cultural violation to not conduct libations. Kwanzaa is celebrated December 26th through January 1st. 7 days of Kwanzaa, where seven candles are lit. The black candle represents the African people. The red candle symbolizes their struggle. And the green candle represents hope for the future. There are seven Kwanzaa principles. December 26th, you would light a black candle to celebrate umoja, which means unity, to strive for and maintain unity in the family, community, and nation. December 27th, you would light a red candle to celebrate Kujichagulia, which means self-determination, to determine ourselves, name ourselves, create for ourselves, and speak for ourselves, instead of being defined, named, created for, or spoken for by others. And on December 28th, you would light a green candle to celebrate Ujima, which is collective work and responsibility, to build and maintain our community together and make our sisters and brothers' problems our problems and solve them together. On December 29th, you would light a red candle to celebrate Ujamaa, which is cooperative economics, to build and maintain our stores, our businesses, and to profit from them together. And on December 30th, you would light a green candle to celebrate Nia, which means purpose, to make our collective vocation the building and developing of our community in order to restore our people to their traditional greatness. On December 31st, you would light a red candle to celebrate Kumba, which is creativity, to always do as much as you can in any way that you can in order to leave our community more beautiful and beneficial than we inherited it. On January 1st, you would light a green candle to celebrate Imani, which means faith, to believe with all your heart in our people, our parents, our teachers, our leaders, and the righteousness and victory of our struggle. Unity, self-determination, collective work and responsibility, cooperative economics, purpose, creativity, faith are the seven principles of Kwanzaa. Ashe.
Kwanzaa is a holiday that was started by Dr. Malenga Karenga in 1966. The reason that he felt a need to start a brand new holiday was because he felt that African Americans that lived outside of the continent of Africa were detached from the values and the culture of the continent of Africa. And he wanted them to feel good about themselves and to have something that they could connect to make their lives better. Kwanzaa is actually derived from a Kiswahili word meaning first harvest. All through the continent of Africa and many other places, people celebrate the harvest. They give thanks for the harvest. So Kwanzaa really means first fruits or harvest time. Kwanzaa is not a religious holiday, it's a cultural holiday, which means that you can celebrate whatever your tradition is and still enjoy Kwanzaa. Kwanzaa is observed the day after Christmas, which means you could still celebrate Christmas, from December 26th all the way through January 1st, New Year's Day, for 7 days. So the 7 days, you're actually celebrating and thinking about seven principles. Those seven principles are called the Nguza Saba. The seven principles of Kwanzaa are Umoja, unity, Kutishangulia, self-determination, Ujima, collective work and responsibility, Ujamaa, cooperative economics, Nia, purpose, Koumba, creativity, and last but not least, Imani, faith. Those are seven principles that everyone can use to have a better life. It doesn't matter if you're African American, it doesn't matter where you're from. These seven principles will help you to be a better human being and also help to make the world a better place. The candelabra for Kwanzaa is called a kinora. It is seven candles that represent, again, the seven principles. So the middle candle is black, that represents the people. Then you have three candles representing the blood, and then three candles that represent the earth or the hard work that you do. I think that what resonates with people about this holiday is that it really is a holiday that makes you look within and then connect with the people around you. So part of Kwanzaa also is looking at your relationships, people who you might need to ask forgiveness from, people who you might need to forgive. The Kwanzaa celebration at the American Museum of Natural History is literally the largest Kwanzaa celebration in the United States. Thousands and thousands of people come in to see the Kwanzaa celebration. And as a storyteller, I am just proud, and every year I look forward to coming and sharing with everyone about Kwanzaa.
We have about 10,000 people that come together to celebrate every year, with shows that include performances as well as storytelling and teaching about the principles and all of the, you know, nature of the holiday of Kwanzaa, as well as a popular marketplace that opens for artisans to come and sell the wares at the museum for just one day.
And you see people of every ethnicity, every race, every religion coming together to celebrate love, to celebrate culture, to celebrate the great and rich contribution of African Americans and the African diaspora. What's wonderful about Kwanzaa for everyone is that it gives everyone the opportunity to learn a little bit more about African American history, which is American history. Then we also get the opportunity to be with family and share personal stories. So when people of any ethnicity come together and they hear these stories, it helps them to understand one another better.
Wow. That was wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Thank you. And thank you once again, Ashika. Now we have a wonderful reading by our CSL West Georgia member, Zizi. She will be reading about Hanukkah. Take it away, Zizi.
Long ago, in the ancient land of Judea, the Jews worshiped in their temple in the holy city of Jerusalem, on Mount Moriah. Within the temple, there were many precious objects. Among the objects was a single flame that was kept burning to symbolize the power of their faith. A king named Antiochus came to their land with a multitude of soldiers and took over the temple. He forbade the Jews to worship in their own way and required them to bow down to the idols of his religion. Those who refused would die. As the faithful watched in horror, the soldiers entered the temple, desecrated it, set fire to the books of law, spilled the lamp oil, and the light in the temple went out. One of the faithful, Mattathias, and his five sons vowed to never forsake God's laws. Instead, they led the Jews against the soldiers. Although they were few, they prayed to God under the starry sky, and the next morning declared to the people, "Do not be afraid, for the Lord is with us. Strength comes from heaven. It is not in the size of the army." The Jews defeated the army and marched triumphantly into Jerusalem and to their abandoned temple. The strong soldiers wept, and they got busy cleansing the temple. They built a new altar, made new holy vessels, and prepared to light the lamp and to rededicate the temple to God. But only one cruse of pure oil could be found. They had oil for only one day. It would take 8 days to get more oil. Judah, one of the sons of Mattathias, took the oil in his hands and said to the people, "Let us yet rejoice in what we have and light the lamp to worship and praise God." The celebration of Hanukkah is a commemoration of that demonstration of faith. Although they had only one cruse of oil and it was not enough, they did bless what they had and gave it. Their dependence was not on oil, it was on God, and God did not fail them.
Wonderful. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same, by the power of the name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyon Adonai. Age to age is still the same, by the power of the name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Ekon Kon Adonai. We will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Through your love and through the ram, you saved the son of Abraham. Through the power of your hand, turned the sea into dry land. To the outcast on her knees, you were the God who really sees. And by your might, you set your children free. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same, by the power of your name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Ekon Kon Adonai. We will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Through the years, you've made it that the time of Christ was near, but all the people couldn't see what Messiah ought to be. Though your word contained the plan, they just could not understand. Your most awesome work was done through the frailty of your son. El Shaddai, El Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same, by the power of the name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Ekon Kon Adonai. I will praise you till I die, El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Shaddai,
age, you're still the same. By the power of the name, El Shaddai, El Shaddai, Ekon Kona Adonai. I will praise you till I die, El Shaddai.
That beautiful songstress is Coco. I neglected to introduce her, but that beautiful rendition, that's Coco. Wonderful, Coco. Absolutely wonderful. By the way, that's my nickname.
Mine too.
Well, we have a wonderful new song, another song by the incomparable Cynthia and Connie. This is going to be such a wonderful treat. Take it away, Cynthia and Connie. Connie, Cynthia, you're muted.
Okay, here I am. Hi. Connie gets to take a break on this one, okay?
Wonderful.
This is one of my favorite Christmas songs, Grown Up Christmas List.
Oh, I love it.
Letter to Santa, December 2020. Dear Santa, do you remember me? I sat upon your knee. I wrote to you with childhood fantasies. Well, I'm all grown up now, but I still need help somehow. I'm not a child, but my heart still can dream. So here's my lifelong wish, my grown-up Christmas list. Not for myself, but for a world in need. No more lives torn apart, and war would never start, and time would heal our hearts. And everyone would have a friend, and right would always win, and love would never end. This is my grown-up Christmas list. As children, we believed that the grandest sight to see was something lovely right beneath the tree. But heaven surely knows that packages and bows can never heal a hurting human soul. No more lives torn apart, war would never start, and time would heal all hearts. Would have a friend, right would always win, and love would never end. This is my grown-up Christmas list.
What is this illusion called the innocence of youth? Maybe only in our blind belief can we ever find the truth. Dear Santa, we've been good here at CSL. We've been really good. So bring us our list. Normal lives torn apart, and war would never start, and time would heal all hurts. Oh, and everyone would have a friend, and right would always win, and love would never end. This is my grown-up Christmas list. This is my only lifelong wish. This is my grown-up Christmas list.
Oh, wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Thank you. That was absolutely wonderful. Thank you, Cynthia. Now help me welcome Eileen. She's going to be reading a Christmas message. Eileen, take it away.
Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Great. Once upon a time, there was a blacksmith who worked hard at his trade. The day came for him to die. The angel was sent to him, and much the angel surprised, he refused to go. He pleaded with the angel to make his case before God, that he was the only blacksmith in the area, and it was time for all of his neighbors to begin their planting and sowing. He was needed. So the angel pleaded his case before God. He said that the man didn't want to appear ungrateful, and that he was glad to have a place in the kingdom, but he would could he just put it off for a little while? And so he was left. About a year or two later, the angel came back again with the same message. The Lord was ready to share the fullness of the kingdom with him. Again, the man had reservations and said, "A neighbor of mine is seriously ill, and it's time for the harvest. A number of us are trying to save his crops so his family won't become destitute. Please come back later." And off the angel went again. Well, it got to be a pattern. And every time the angel came back, the blacksmith had one excuse or another. The blacksmith would just shake his head and tell the angel where he was needed and declined. Finally, the blacksmith grew very old, weary, and tired. He decided it was time. So he prayed, "God, if you send me your angel today, I'll be glad to come home now." Immediately, the angel appeared as if from around the corner of the bed. The blacksmith said, "If you want to take me home, I'm ready to live forever in the kingdom of heaven." And the angel laughed and looked at the blacksmith in delight and surprise and said, "Where do you think you've been all these years?" He was home.
Yeah. That was absolutely beautiful and poignant. Thank you, Eileen.
Thank you for having me read it, because the first time I read it, I've cried.
I understand. Now we have a real treat, everyone. Reverend Dr. Sandra Jackson, Kathy, our CSL member, Gloria, another CSL member, will be candle lighting, doing our candle lighting ceremony, in addition to a wonderful short message. Take it away, ladies.
Okay, so we didn't communicate well with Gloria, so it's just gonna be Kathy and I, okay?
Okay.
So I want to begin by saying that for some of you, this may be a very unusual Christmas program. You're probably expecting it to all be about, you know, a Christian type Christmas. And we have included Hanukkah and we've included Kwanzaa. And I like to do all of those because those all come in December. That's number one. Number two, they're all about light. They all use candles in some way. And so I like to integrate them all together. And that's what we've done today. And I hope that if this is your first experience of understanding about Kwanzaa or about Hanukkah, that it has been a positive one. And so now we're going to talk about Christmas, and we're going to talk about Christ consciousness and having that be that which is birthed in you. Ordinarily, the candle lighting service is done, number one, at night, number two, in the dark, with all the lights out. So if it's convenient for you, you can turn your lights out so you can have that sense. Because what happens during the candle lighting service is that you start with one candle and you light one at a time, and the room becomes lighter and brighter and brighter, because what we're learning is the light dispels the darkness, okay? It's a ritual. So I want you to use your imagination with your with this ritual. And to begin, I'm going to turn out my light. Okay. All right, so rituals are very powerful experiences. Many spiritual rituals have lost their power over years because people participate in them unconsciously. So I want to encourage you today to participate in this consciously, to really listen. Rituals are to be undertaken as an experience, not just like a nice little ceremony. The Christmas candle lighting ritual can be very powerful ritual. While it is preferable for us to experience it together in a darkened room so that we may experience the light dispelling darkness, that is not possible this year. And so we must use our imagination and not allow our circumstances to diminish the impact of our experience. What is the Christ consciousness? It is the realization of the presence of God within you. It is beyond belief. It is what you know and identify yourself to be. Jesus said, "I and the Father are of one accord." He also said, "He who has seen me has seen the Father." Tomorrow is December 21st. It is the shortest day of the year. That is, we have the fewest hours of daylight tomorrow. It is the end of the autumn season and the beginning of winter. Winter is a time of darkness. Spiritually, it is a very powerful time, for it is a time when we can end what is no longer appropriate and conceive of something that is new. Conception occurs in darkness. Sometimes it occurs in the darkness of ignorance. Sometimes it occurs in the darkness of our physical conception and the beginning of our journey to our earthly bodies. And sometimes conception occurs with our intention to set forth on a new path in our lives. Decide now. Are you ready to conceive? Be willing to be open and available to the divine Christ consciousness and its possibility for your life. Be willing to let go of whatever no longer serves you. Open yourself to the greater awareness of your divine self being birthed during this Christmas season. This period of time is a very powerful, energetic time, and you can now set your intentions to be something more than you have been in the past. An angel came separately to Mary and Joseph in the darkness of their dreams to tell them of the conception of their child. Angels in the Bible are messengers of God. They are our enlightened spiritual ideas. You too have enlightened ideas, so do not push them away. Do not deny them. They may come in the form of a dream or the darkness of grief and despair. They may come when you are the most fearful or angry. They are, however, ethereal and light. You may miss them because you are focused on the darkness. So today, the angel is inviting you to a new life experience. Everything begins with spirit, with God. And so we're going to use this candle. We're going to light this candle. To represent our oneness with God. All of the other candles will be lit from this one candle because, like I said, God is the beginning. And by the way, the reason I had Coco sing El Shaddai is another name for God. So we're going to light this candle. Unfortunately, you won't be able to see the candles. I will light them and then we'll, you know what I mean. I'll set them aside. Okay. The order in which Jesus called the disciples provides us with clues as to what the spiritual, mental, and emotional faculties we will need in order to guide the delicate new awareness of our divinity from the darkness of conception into the light of our lives. When conception occurs, there may be no visible sign of acceptance. So we must have faith that something has happened. Jesus called Peter first because he represents faith. He knew that with the work he has to do, faith would be needed, strong faith for those who would follow him. And so I am lighting the candle of faith.
After the conception, there is a gestation period. You may be carrying the holy child, the Christ consciousness as an idea, a project, a new relationship, any new possibility for you, for yourself or others. No one knows of it. And so the impositions of the world are taxing. Just as Mary and Joseph were taxed, so too are we taxed. That is, we incur obstacles along the path of creation. Our frustration that things are not happening as we desire can drain the energy we need to nurture the newness with us. Mary and Joseph were taxed and wearied by the journey, by their journey, but they labored on, and so must you. To do so, you will need the strength to maintain the protection needed by that which is goring in the darkness of your mind. You will need mental and emotional stability, and you will need to stay focused. I light the candle of strength. Judgment. Judgment is the ability to make right, sound decisions. Decisions that cause greater good to come into the world by means of you. This, not just about yourself. You want whatever you are birthing to be good for others in the world as well. I light the candle of judgment. You would think love would be the first thing needed, but love, unconditional love, requires strength. There are many reasons to close off your heart and protect yourself from the hurts of the world. But in doing so, you lock yourself into a prison that separates you from the love and the good that comes our way. You must learn to open your heart to love. I light the candle of love.
Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem to pay their taxes. And yet, arriving, No one recognized them and gave them shelter. Instead, alone, they made a bed in the lowly place of an animal stall. Like Mary and Joseph, you will need to stay focused when no one else is paying any attention, when you are not being recognized for the good you are doing. You must continue the practices that bring forth the good you desire. You must demonstrate that you are living a new life, even when no one notices. This is where your power is, within yourself, not in the world that provides the accolades and acknowledgement. I'm lighting the candle of power.
Our imagination allows us to live into our desire. It allows us to see into the future and imagine how we want it to be. Here is where that which you have conceived, that which is gestating with you becomes an image. When a child has been conceived, its reality comes when the first heartbeats are felt. With the birthing of our new consciousness, a clarity begins to form in our mind. The fuzziness of possibility begins to take form as an image, an awareness that our desire that actually happened. I light the candle of imagination. While Mary and Joseph traveled to Bethlehem, a star guided the Magi, the three kings to the birth of the child. The star in the sky lights the darkness and provides guidance to the shepherds and the Magi. The star represents the light of understanding that despite darkness and fear, confusion and chaos, what knowledge and understanding do you need to acquire to support the new life growing with you? Too often we want to create something new while not changing our current circumstances. When people become parents, it is an unalterable life experience. You will never not be a parent. You will be a parent with a child that you live with and raise, or one that something we never want to experience. The parent of a child who has died. But you will always be a parent. But we are parents to our dreams, our desires, Too often we caught up in the worldly activities and forget to get the necessary understanding that allows us to support our forward growth and awareness. I light the candle of understanding.
The next two faculties go together. They are will and order. Will represents God's will. Before the new appears, there will be conflict. The conflict that arises in the question, shall I move forward? Shall I take this job? Shall I marry this person? Is this the opportunity and answer to my prayer, or is this a detour? Physicist Fred Allen Wolf says that inertia comes along with creativity. We will always be challenged to align with our desire or to slip into the ways of the past. God's will is always good. It is always more. It is always greater than what has been, because God is the essence of creativity. Ask yourself, what would God want me to do? What is God's will in this situation? Then listen, realizing that there are times when we hear what we want to hear, not what is the true will of God. Order is about being in alignment and harmony with the will of God. And so I light two candles, one for the will of God and one for order.
Renunciation is our 10th candle. What is renunciation? It is about eliminating that which is incompatible with new life that is growing within us. Sometimes we need to eliminate life-destroying bad habits, replacing them with giving habits. Sometimes the change we need to make are big, but not oftentimes they are the little things to do which we have become attached. What do you need to renounce, to release and let go of in order to birth a new life? Mary and Joseph had to let go of the life where they lived. They had to journey a long distance. They had to renounce all that they knew to the journey to a land and give birth. Not among family and friends, but in an animal stall far from home. But their reward was a new life. You too will be rewarded. Renounce what is no longer applicable to your life. I light the candle, renunciation.
When you renounce the past or that which is no longer belongs to your life, you experience zeal. Zeal is the energy and enthusiasm that comes when your life overflows with joy. As the candle of zeal is lit, realize that there are days that contain joy. Perhaps a new habit to acquire is necessary. And is finding joy in each and every day and allowing yourself to be filled with the gratitude for it. The Magi are representative of high, lofty intellectual thought. The manger represents the simplicity of mind and understanding. They come together as the Christ child is born in simplicity and is worshiped by that which is exalted. As we bring forth new life, we must remember to remain humble and grateful while reaching for that which is beyond our reach. To do so, we invite the symbol of the last candle, which is life. Choose to live life to the fullest. Choose to let the radiant joy of the Christ consciousness fill your entire being. Go forth in love and joy, filled with the faith, the strength, and the power of the divine, which is your true self. It is your source and it is your guide. Awake each morning and live each day in the gratitude of knowing that the Christ, the divine life, is alive in me. So we have the God candle, which has lit all the others. And this is the candle of life. It is your life. Go forth today and every day being all that you possibly can be. If you have a candle at home, I would suggest that you light it today and know that it is the light that you are contributing to the wholeness that and the light that we have done here today, because that's what we would do if we were together. That's what I mean. Thank you. Good job. Okay. All right, Dorothea, Take it away.
Thank you, Reverend Dr. Sandra Jackson. And thank you, Kathy. That was very enlightening. Now we have a wonderful song sung by Susan. Susan, take it away.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary soul rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. Oh, no.
That is absolutely wonderful. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm going to turn this over to our operations manager, this is our offering. And our operations manager, Marcia, is going to take it away.
I think I like my new title. Okay. Awesome. Oh gosh. I have to get myself together from that last song. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Breath. Anyway. Okay. Thank you. So there are three ways that you can support our center in your conscious giving. You can either do PayPal if you want to do an online donation. And I will put all of these links and everything in our chat window. They're also showing up during our, I'm all emotional after that song. I'm sorry. Let me try it again. So you can do PayPal. You can, if you want to support our center electronically, you can mail a check to our address if you feel more comfortable mailing a check. This is the season of giving, and Amazon is doing a whole lot to help us out with giving. And if you are an Amazon shopper, there's going to be a link in the chat window in a second that will allow you to then connect with us. And Amazon has a charitable giving program that if you connect with CSL West Georgia through the link, that's the easiest way to do it. Anytime that you shop at Amazon and you go to smile.amazon.com instead of amazon.com, Amazon will take a portion of what you spend with them and donate it back to our center. So those are our three ways. And what I'm going to do is I am going to put on our affirmation. And I just realized it was in a different file. So here we go.
Yeah.
I am grateful for the divine givingness circulating abundantly through my life, my community, and my world. And so it is. Yes.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much. Now, this is the portion of the show where Dr. Reverend Sandra Jackson will be doing our closing words and our wonderful prayer.
Oh, thank you all so much for being here today. This was absolutely amazing, amazing. And here's the really amazing thing about it. If we were not in quarantine in our homes, if we were not virtual and had not been practicing all these months to get it right, we would not have Coco here. She lives in California. We would not have Susan here. She's also Californian. And let me see, who else? Anybody? If we have Phil and Gloria, well, if we were on, you know, doing Facebook Live, they may be here. But you know, the thing is that so many of us would not be here. Easy and Ruth are all from Nevada. So it is so wonderful that we have the opportunity. There's something good in everything, isn't there? Even this year. So I want to encourage you to look back this year while you're in the process of finishing whatever your preparations are for Christmas. Think in terms of the past year and what wonderful things have happened in spite of all the difficulties there were. There's something beautiful that has gone on as well. We have to look for it sometimes. And I just want to thank everybody who participated today, the readers, the singers, just you guys just outdid yourselves, each and every one. Floyd and Mike, thank you so much for participating today. You just, you know, we would be getting a standing ovation right now if we were all together standing. So, yeah, all right, everybody, shake it out, okay? Thank you so very much, so very much. Marcia, I know the challenges were there today, and you know what? The little gremlins sometimes show up for us when we least expect them, but it all worked out in the end, and that's what was important. Jeez, I don't want to let you guys go because I am just so filled. All my favorite songs were sung today. So thank you so much. I really appreciate it all for you, each and every one of you. And we were going to announce how much money we were giving to the food bank, and I forgot to call Marcia and ask her to get that done. We were all busy. Yeah, she forgot to. Anyway, we'll announce it next week. So if you were planning to do the food bank, go online today and do it. Just use the link for donating. You can donate. One of the choices is the food bank in there. Jeez. What a wonderful day. What a wonderful day. Lily reminded us, the Christmas star tomorrow, the Christmas star is the one that they believe the Magi's were following. And, you know, so that's the famous star. So be sure and look at where you are, because some of us are 3 hours behind the rest of us. And so, or earlier. And so check it out and see where you are. And just probably can just Google Christmas star and it'll tell you where it is. But you know, if you get a chance, please go see it tomorrow night. Okay. Oh, what a blessing it is. Let us just close our eyes and turn within and just breathe, just breathe, just breathe, just breathe. Just breathe into this moment. Breathe into the blessedness of this moment. Breathe with the deep gratitude and thanksgiving. I am surrounded by the candles that we have lit during this ceremony. I feel their warmth. And I know that right where you are, there is the warmth of God's love as well. That it may not be candlelight, but it is the light of God's will, God's love, God's joy, God's peace, God's wisdom. All the goodness that there possibly is right here, right now, right where you are. So just open your heart, open your mind, open your entire beingness to the realization that I am that I am, that the Christ is alive and well and growing and expanding in my life. I am creating a greater awareness of the I am that I am, and it is exploding in all aspects of my life. I am knowing that right here and right now, there is a truth that I am coming to a greater understanding of, and it is changing my life for the better, for the greater, for the more good. I am opening myself that I may be divinely guided by God's will, and I am letting my faith lead me and strengthen me in the paths of all the days that I walk this earth. I'm knowing that right here, right now, right where I am whole, perfect, and complete, unfolding in the beauty, the joy, and the love that is God. I am as wise as any of the wise men who were there with the Christ child. I am humble as the shepherds who met his birth as well. And I am that Christedness. I am Mary, I am Joseph, I am all, because I am spirit expressing in the forms in which I am. And that form is all forms. And so with deep gratitude and thanksgiving for all that we have experienced this morning, for all the talent, for all the giving, for all the creativity, for all the love, for all the joy, for all the peace, for all the wisdom and all the desires for greatness, I am here and now knowing that all is well. And I release this word now, knowing it is done in each one of our lives as we embrace it fully and completely as our own. And so it is. Amen. And let us acknowledge Dorothea for her wonderful, brilliant mastering of ceremonies. Thank you, Dorothea. Great job. All right. Marcia.
This is another one of the original songs that I wrote, I made up. again, I wanted to talk about the season, because that's what I think is the most important thing here that we're celebrating is how we go round and round this crazy sun every year. We go round and round, and this is the time that we look back on all the things that we've harvested, you know, all the things that we created. And the time that we gather together and think about what we want to do next year, you know, what we want to accomplish, where we want to be, where we want to go. That's what we do. So I thought that we could get together and we could light, you know. The seasons are the contrast. To let go of all our past and let go of what's to come. Write down your excuses, turn them into dust, plant the seeds of change, water it with trust.
Choose only love. Choose only love.
what is inside of you, inside of me, and that's the light that they see.
The season of change. Yes, it is. And, you know, one of the drawbacks of being virtual is that we don't always know who the visitors are. So if you're visiting here for today, thank you so very much for visiting. We really appreciate it. Please do come back. We would love to see you again and show up, and then we'll know who you are and know that you're a visitor. Okay. All right. Thank you so very much, everybody, for being here. We're going to end the meeting, but if you would like to stay on and fellowship for a few minutes and talk and ask questions about the candle lighting and all that, ZZ always wants to know what those principles are, you know. So if any of that you want to know, please just stay on for a little while and we'll talk. In the meantime, don't forget about the Christmas star tomorrow night, and who knows, you may have a wise person experience just like the wise men did. Okay, anyway, have a great weekend or great Christmas. Oh, it'll be after Christmas when we get together next week, so have a great Christmas. Okay, everybody, bye. We go forth today knowing that we are God's blessing in the world. Only good goes from us and only good comes to us. And so it is. Go be the blessing that you are. All right. Thank you.